coming in.
Something wrong?
Yes, yes. You. You're a pea head. I'm not stupid. I do know the science.
Come on, Sarah. You're not one of those I don't need drugs to have a good time geeks.
Yeah, but it's more than just good times with you, isn't it? You are completely addicted.
Oh, don't be such a nana.
It's over, okay? I don't want to see you anymore.
It's the reason you wanted to have this conversation here.
Mm-hmm. Your stuff's at the front door. Unless one of your dodgy friends hasn't nicked it already. Key, please.
What did you think I was going to do? Get all psycho on you, bash you around?
Like you did to your mother. Yeah, I know all about that. You need help.
You're right. I'm in a bad place right now. But if you write me off, please, babe, you're the only good thing in my life.
Well, I am just the idiot who provided you with a place to crash, and there is no way you're going to keep budging off me.
No, I'm not. I've got a loan coming through. I can pay off all my debts. I'll be a totally different...
I don't want to hear it, Mackie. It's finished. We are over. It was over days ago, and it's not like it was the romance of the century anyway. It was just a bit of fun. I still get kicked in the teeth. Key, please.
Hi. You're looking a little better.
I'll be better when I know I'm not HIV positive.
Of course. And you're not. All the results came back negative.
Oh, my God. Thank you. So there's no doubt I don't need any other tests.
Well, if, as you say, you didn't have sex with George in the last 2 weeks.
No. He wasn't exactly a red-hot lover. But what about all the other stuff, all those hideous diseases?
You're fine. Perfectly healthy.
Thank you, Dr. Weston. You have been truly amazing.
Well, it's always a pleasure to be the bearer of good news.
No excuse not to get a job now. Maybe I'll go for something here. Filing clerk will be okay.
Bit of a step down for you.
No stress. I could do with that. So I'll probably be seeing you around.
Excellent.
I'm just on my way to work.
You're rested on today?
No, but I thought I might catch up on some study and stuff.
Do you spend any time at home these days? Sorry, I didn't come here to hassle you.
Good, because I wouldn't like you to ruin my mood. I think I just had a breakthrough with Mum. If I keep working at her, I reckon I might be able to get her to kick that scumbag to the curb.
You shouldn't talk about your dad like that. Not when you don't...
If you've got something to say, then say it.
Gus is illiterate.
What?
He can't read or write.
Yeah, I know what it means. I just don't know why you think that.
Well, I noticed a few things, and then when I kind of found him out, he couldn't deny it.
Nah, he's having you on. He wrote me letters from inside.
He must have dictated them.
So, wait a sec. Say I decide to buy this. I mean, does it actually change anything? Sure, it shows that he can't hold down a job, but it doesn't excuse the stealing, the leeching off of Mum.
Yeah, okay, maybe not. But it's got to be making things harder for him and holding him back. And he would never admit to you that he has a problem because he doesn't want you to think even worse of him. I know that you wouldn't, but he's just so ashamed. He needs your support, Baxter. It's the only way he's going to sort himself out.
Mrs. Jeffries.
I think that Huya would call me Yvonne.
Please don't interrupt, Mrs. Jeffries. It's extraordinarily rude.
I don't think Huya would talk to me like that.
Who's running this interview?
You are. You're making me more nervous than I already am.
I'm preparing you for every eventuality, Mother. Mark, hi.
Hi. Okay, I've made a decision. I don't want us to break up.
Why not? I mean, don't get me wrong, I don't want to break up either, but I cheated on you.
You made a mistake. And to be honest, I reckon we've got a lot in common.
Is this where you tell me you've done the dirty too?
No, I've been entirely faithful. Look, let's just start again. You know, wipe the slate clean and take it from here.
I would love that.
There you go, and change. Thank you. Hi.
Jane, when can I get my money?
Excuse me, when it's in the bank. I can't just snap my fingers and make them put it in there.
Ro, thank God, you get the stuff? I'm running out of time here.
I almost got busted, Mickey.
I can't do it, I can't.
Do you not realize how serious this is? If I don't make a lot of cash fast, then I am dead. I'm actually dead. There's 1,800 there. This is all I've got.
1,800 isn't even going to begin to...
You're a doctor, mate. You can't tell me that's all the cash you've got.
I'm a doctor with a student loan.
That's gratitude for you, huh? I must have given you 20 times that over the years.
I'm sorry, bro. This is the best I can do. I presumed you wanted this holiday to start immediately.
You know this whole thing is just as hard for me as it is for you, harder probably. But I've booked you in for one of these courses, the one that has...
I've already told you I'm not doing anger management.
And I told you that as CEO I can make it mandatory.
You know, you are the only person who has a problem with what I did in ED. I've got a whole team in there who will swear black and blue that I was only doing what needed to be done to save a colleague.
And Sarah Potts is the president of this little fan club, is she?
Now we get to the bottom of this rank pooling of yours.
If you're suggesting that what I'm doing isn't in any way personal, then you can
think... I don't give a stuff if it's personal or professional. You can do whatever you like. Stand me down, report me to the board, whatever. But I am in the right here. And I will never, ever apologise for what I did.
That psalm that I was telling you about last night.
Right, well, it's obviously a big deal to you, so we better hear it then.
Okay. Who shall ascend the hill of the Lord? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not lift up his soul to what is false, and does not swear deceitfully.
Okay, and this relates to me somehow, does it?
It's about honesty. About the importance of truth. See, Dad, I want to be able to trust you. I really do. I've got this for you too.
That's more my style, music. It's a bit of Christian rock, is it?
It's the Bible. See, I know it can be a bit of a drag to read the whole thing, but if you chuck that on while you're having a coffee...
Don't bullshit me, Baxter.
Hey?
You go on about truth and you're too scared to talk straight to me.
I'm just trying to establish a connection here, Dad. I thought that was what you wanted.
I don't want this garbage. It's bad enough listening to you spouting on prayers and the rest of it. You don't want this person, Baxter. You're just throwing yourself into it because you're so bloody afraid.
Oh, yeah, and what am I so afraid of?
Oh, you want some honesty. Behind all this Bible bashing, you're still the same kid who used to get a kick out of what we used to do. You're Baxter Cormack, son of Gus Cormack, car thief and petty crim. You're just like me, and you know it.